Hi, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll learn about the Common Information Model, or CIM, and the benefits of making your data CIM compliant. In most deployments, data comes from multiple source types. As a result, the same values of data can occur under many different field names. As an example, in our Access Combined source type, we have an IP address field named Client IP, which can include some of the same values as the User IP field in our Cisco WSA SQUID source type. At search time, we may want to normalize these different occurrences to a common structure and naming convention, allowing us to correlate events from both source types. Splunk supports the use of a Common Information Model, or CIM, to provide a methodology for normalizing values to a common field name. The CIM uses a schema to define standard fields between sources. Splunk premium solutions like Splunk Enterprise Security or Splunk IT Service Intelligence rely heavily on data that is CIM compliant when searching data, running reports, and creating dashboards. Splunk provides a CIM add-on at SplunkBase that includes JSON data model files that help you validate your index data for compliance, use normalized data in pivots, and can help improve performance through data model acceleration. The add-on is free and does no additional indexing, so will not affect your license in any way. The add-on should only be installed on search heads or single-instance deployments of Splunk. To install the add-on, we click on the gear at the top of the app sidebar on our search head and click the Browse More Apps button. Here we can search for the CIM add-on. We click on the Install button and enter our splunk.com username and password. We accept the terms and conditions and click the Login and Install button. After installing, we click Go Home to continue. There are a few steps that you need to take to use the CIM with your data. In this demo, we already have data indexed in our Splunk environment and a good understanding of what the data is. So our first step will be to examine our data in the context of the CIM. The add-on created a set of pre-configured data models on our Splunk instance. To see them, we click on the Data Models link in the Settings menu. One thing to note about the CIM data models, they are not accelerated by default. In the documentation for the add-on, we can find reference tables for each data model. These contain object names, required tags for the objects, field names for the object, and the type of data that field is expected to contain. They come in extremely handy when deciding how to map your data to the CIM data models. We have read the reference tables and know that the data we will be using for this demo fits best with the web data model. We select it from the data model list. In the data model, there is a web event root dataset and a proxy and storage child dataset with inherited, extracted, and calculated attributes predefined. The constraint includes a macro and a tag of web. This macro evaluates to a search of the indexes we want the data model to search. By default, a data model will search across all our indexes. To limit which indexes the data model can search and improve performance, we select Manage Apps from the App menu and click the Setup link for the Splunk Common Information Model add-on. Selecting the tab for the web data model, we can choose the indexes to restrict the data model to. We wish to use this data model with our online sales and web security appliance data, so we add in the web and network indexes and click Save. Returning to our data model, we see that it requires a tag of web to be added to the events we want to use with this data model. Since we have yet to tag any data with the web tag, when we try to create a pivot, we won't see any events returned. To tag our data, we create event types for events and give them tags. We do this by selecting event types from the settings menu and clicking the New Event Type button. We select the destination app for our event type and give it a name. We are going to be using data from our indexed web logs and Cisco Web Security Appliance data, so we add the search terms that return these events. We add a tag of web and click Save. Now if we create a pivot, we get a count of events for the tag. Looking at our reference table, we see that the SRC data model field should contain information on the client that requested the connection. But if we try to split rows using the field, all that is returned is unknown events. This is because in the Access Combined data, the field is called Client IP, while in our Cisco Web Security Appliance data, it is called User IP. To normalize our fields and make them SIM compliant, we will create SRC field aliases for these two fields.
We could also create new field extractions or write lookups to satisfy the requirement. But with our data, field aliases will suffice.
To create a new field alias, we go to Settings, Fields, and click the Add New link for field aliases. We will select or confirm the destination app, in this case, Search. Give the alias a name and enter in the source type for the alias to be applied to. For our Access Combined source type, we want to alias the Client IP field to SRC. So we put Client IP into the left input and the alias name SRC into the right and click Save. We create another field alias for the Cisco WSA SQUID source type. This time, creating the SRC alias for the user IP field. Now when we run the pivot and split by SRC, we see a count of our events with the normalized SRC field. We can also search our data model and see that we are receiving events from both source types and values for our normalized SRC field. To make all your data SIM compliant, we would now create field aliases for the rest of the fields in the data model.
Thanks for joining us to learn more about Splunk's Common Information Model. To continue your journey learning about Splunk, we suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.